So good day everyone, welcome to this course entitled Electrotechnology 3 or Marine Electricity and Electrical Maintenance. So I'm Louie, Juera, your lecturer for this semester. So our topic for this week is about direct current or DC generators. So by the end of this lecture, you are expected to understand the basic operation, the parts, and be able to sketch the circuit diagram of a simple DC generator. So to illustrate the concepts, we will be using Hunter x Hunter, Ninja Moves, and Faradays Law. And to make it more practical, we will dissect a DC generator using a 3D model. So for this entire series lecture, we will be using the Marine Electrical Technology book by Elston Fernandez as a main reference. So let's get started. So by definition, an electrical generator is a machine which converts mechanical energy into electrical energy. So all electric generators operate on the same principle, regardless whether they produce AC or DC. Internally, all generators produce alternating current or AC. If DC or direct current is required, a device called commutator is used to rectify or change from AC to DC. So the electromotive force, EMF or voltage, is produced according to Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, named after an English scientist, Michael Faraday. So the first law states that whenever a conductor cuts the flux of the magnetic field, an EMF is produced in the conductor. So to illustrate this principle, let us take a look at this experiment clip from Physics High. So the diagram for this experiment is shown here. So we have three components, namely the galvanometer, which measures small amount of voltage or current, the conductor in a form of coil, and the magnet. So the broken lines around the magnet is the magnetic field. So the magnetic field is the invisible area around a magnet in which there is a magnetic force. So if you are a fan of Hunter x Hunter, so this is similar to the concept of Nen. In this case, the aura surrounding Gon and Killua. But in this experiment, it is the area around the magnet represented by the broken lines. So based on the first law of electromagnetic induction, if these magnetic fields represented by these circular red lines will be cut by the conductor in the form of coil, then voltage will be induced, represented by the deflection or movement of the needle in the galvanometer. So based from this clip, what can you observe? The most obvious thing that you can see here is the warrior with big swords. So this person represents the cutting of the magnetic field by the conductor. And every time this warrior moves or attacks, the needle moves back and forth. So this indicates that there is an induced voltage or current in the loop. So another observation is when the magnet is in the coil for a couple of seconds or outside the coil. Observe that the needle returns to zero. So this implies that if the magnet will not move, then there is no generated voltage or EMF. So this leads to the question, how can we increase the induced voltage? So the second law answers this question. So the second law of electromagnetic induction states that the magnitude of the induced EMF is directly proportional to the rate of change of flux linkage. So this can be illustrated by this animation. Based on this experiment, what can you observe? If you make the magnet moves faster in and out, 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 in the hole of the coil, then you will be able to reach the peak. Now, this is why this is called Faradays Law. So, kidding aside, this law means that increasing the rate in which the magnetic field is being cut, then there will be an increase of voltage. So, these two laws are the building blocks of a generator. This is the 3D model of a DC generator from GrabCAD.com, created by Joel Calarical. So, let us first remove some parts of this model. So this portion here is the stator or the stationary part. So this is the rotor or the rotating part. There are two basic windings, the armature and the field winding. So the wires that you can see here is the armature winding. So these windings are the same as the coil in the experiment that we had a while ago, as shown in this circuit. So this black curve is the magnet that represents the field windings. There are four types of DC generators based on their field of excitation methods, namely the series wound, the shunt wound, the compound wound, and the permanent magnet generators. So this model that we have here is a permanent magnet type generator. So generators with field windings is shown in this figure here. So let us now identify some parts and their functions. So this is the magnetic frame or the yoke. So it is made of cast steel or rolled steel for large machines, and for the smaller size machine, the yoke is generally made of cast iron. So the two main purposes of the yoke are as follows. Number one, it supports the poles and provides mechanical protection to the inner part of the machines. Number two, it provides a low reluctance path for the magnetic flux. So the pull core and the pull shoe. So the pull core and pull shoes are fixed to the magnetic frame by bolt. So usually the pull core and shoes are made of thin cast steel or iron laminations, which are riveted together under the hydraulic pressure. So the poles are laminated to reduce eddy current loss. The field coil or field windings. So when direct current passes through the field winding, it magnetizes the poles, which in turn produces the flux. So meaning it becomes a magnet. However, in our 3D model, it uses a permanent magnet that serves as the field winding. This is the rotating part of the DC generator called the armature. So the armature core of a DC generator is cylindrical in shape and keyed to the rotating shaft. The armature core of a DC generator or machine serves the following purposes. Number one, it houses the conductors in the slot. And it provides an easy path for the magnetic flux. So the armature winding. So the insulated conductors are placed in the slots of the armature core. This arrangement of conductors is called the armature winding. So the armature winding is the heart of the DC machine. So the commutator, it is the most important part of a DC machine and serves the following purposes. Number one, it connects the rotating armature conductor to the external circuit through the brushes. Number two, it converts the induced alternating current in the armature conductor into unidirectional current in the external load circuit in DC generator. The last is the brushes. So the brushes are pressed upon the commutator and form the connecting link between the armature winding and the external circuit. So let us now discuss how this generator produces electricity. So using the circuit of the experiment that we had as shown here. If we move the magnet back and forth, this circuit will generate electricity following the Faradays law of electromagnetic induction. However, we can also generate voltage if we are going to move this coil back and forth while the magnet is fixed. So this is the method used in this generator. So the magnet is fixed to the frame of the motor producing the magnetic field. So the conductor in the armature is rotating continuously while cutting the magnetic field. So this is the same as moving the coil back and forth the magnet. Since the magnetic field is being cut, hence the current will flow through the commutator to the brushes, to the red and green wires, thus creating electricity. This is only the basic working principles of how a generator works. You can read additional materials for a thorough discussion. So in the next lecture, we will discuss separately excited and self-excited generators. So if you have some questions or clarifications, please comment below and I will try to answer your questions as soon as I can. So good luck and God bless.